Gunshots erupt in Rock Island last night where police were searching for evidence.
Plus, finding a way to tackle gun violence. We rode along with the new Davenport Police Gun Unit to see what it takes to keep you safe.
WHBF is local for you. This is Local 4 News This Morning.
Good morning, everybody, on this Friday morning. I'm Rendrick Terry.
And I'm Alexandria Ikomoni. Thanks for watching Local 4 News This Morning. Right now, the Rock Island Police Department is investigating after shots were fired. It's this morning's top story.
It happened around 10 at Lincoln Park on 38th Street. That's across from Augustana College. Local 4 News was first on the scene. Officers recovered at least 6 shell casings from the park's parking lot. No word on any injuries at this time.
Speaking of that, we're getting more reports of shots or shootings in the Quad Cities, especially in the city of Davenport. Now, a new unit in the police department is working on that problem.
Yeah, we're not going to show you the officers on this team because of the sensitive nature of their work. Local 4 Sean Logging took a ride with the gun unit as the team works to stop the bullets in this Local 4 News exclusive.
Get behind him. Stay on him. Stay on him. Oh, man.
The precarious nature of police work.
This is part of it. Definitely is. Not what we want.
The Davenport Police Department gun unit is after a sly suspect.
Our guy's wanted. Okay. So we're going to go out with him on his warrants. And he's got a chance of him being in possession of either drugs or a gun.
It started earlier in the day when some on this 5-member team were waiting, keeping close watch of the suspect's house.
See if we can get the target identified and get him out of the house. Part of the reason as to why we want to get some of our targets out of their homes is for safety reasons.
Then comes the effort to stay on his tail, but not noticeable.
Surveillance is not as easy. Northbound through 5 points. He's going to turn eastbound on Pleasant.
But sometimes this cat and mouse game doesn't end as desired.
We don't have him anymore. Let's send a couple guys back down to the address.
It's only some of the challenges the sergeant who leads this newly developed unit says they face.
Either way now.
If someone gets shot or a house gets shot up and they don't want to be the victim of the crime, the case gets closed. And we will pick that up on the back end of it and see if we know who did it.
DPD's gun unit officially launched in October 2018.
See, we were looking for the most efficient way to follow up on gun events in the city. Previously, we were having different units within the department follow up on these.
Part of the inception was what happened in the city in 2017.
2017 was a rough, long year for our detectives.
Davenport saw about a dozen homicides that year, twice what the city experienced in the years prior. It left little time for detectives to follow up on other gun incidents the way the gun unit now can.
We hit the streets running.
We are getting after these investigations quicker. We're responding quicker. We're making quicker arrests on them. But the other part of that is we're getting information out to everybody faster about the results of these investigations.
They're making strides.
With the different backgrounds that we've had for gang, street crimes, tactical, crime prevention, all of that, I always tell the guys it makes a good puzzle.
In the first 5 months of 2019, the gun unit has collected 34 guns, and the whole department has retrieved 140.
One of the guns we believe was used possibly in 2 shots fired on the west side of Davenport.
Also, for the 2 months the gun unit was running in 2018, they collected 16 guns, and the department as a whole had 351 for all of last year.
Some of the guns that we come into would be in domestic cases, and we may have a gun charge for the domestic-related offense. Maybe you have a suicidal mental health concern.
They also execute multiple search warrants on open cases. Here they're searching a home for a suspect wanted for a shots fired incident a few weeks before.
Didn't get what we wanted, but we got a little bit of something.
There's a trend of shootings that might be related to a group of people, and we discover that as a gun unit, we're able to get that information out to everybody quicker.
They're piecing together how to stop bullets from exiting the barrel of a gun.
We're looking at all firearms events within the city to kind of address it holistically.
All right. Ready to roll?
Yep. In Davenport, Sean Balking, Local 4 News.
Guys, we're 1060.
The gun unit also works closely with the U.S. Attorney's Office in Davenport. For some of these cases, they say it allows them to get tougher punishments for gun crimes.
Stanley Lickens is heading to prison for life without parole for killing a young girl almost 30 years ago. That punishment was made after his third conviction in this case. A Scott County attorney tells Local 4 News the judge also denied Lickens' motion for a new trial. The judge says the jury heard plenty of evidence to justify the conviction. A jury in Waterloo found him guilty last month of murdering 9-year-old Jennifer Lewis in 1990. The girl from Rock Island was found dead in a field near Jefferson Elementary School, and that was in Davenport. Two earlier trials also ended with convictions, but they were overturned on appeal. A third trial ended in a hung jury.
The names of the two East Moline police officers in last weekend's officer-involved shooting have been released. Officers Ryan Clark and Logan Wolf fired at 25-year-old Darryl Strunk. Investigators say Strunk fired at them first during a traffic stop. Both officers are on paid administrative leave. Now, Strunk is now in jail on weapons charges after being released from the hospital. Investigators say he had a semi-automatic pistol.
Businesses in downtown Davenport are still affected by the historic flooding. Some are affected to the point where they need to make permanent decisions. Now, Dress for Success tells Local 4 News about 50% of its merchandise was destroyed or donated to other nonprofits. Now, it won't go back to its old location, and the property owner decided to sell the building after the flooding.
Very precarious situation for us. Obviously, lots of things that we would be doing. Some fundraising, capacity building, the staff doing their jobs basically is all on hold, and you can't recapture those losses.
Dress for Success is currently working from donated space on Elmore Avenue for a short term. Managers hope to find a permanent location later this summer and plan to have a clothing drive and fundraiser next month. We have that information for you at ourquadcities.com.
For them, for sure. 6:07 now on this Friday morning. Talking about all this rain, and it hasn't helped our flooding, but thankfully today we are expecting a nice break from it.
Absolutely. It's payday for a lot of people. It's going to be nice to go on the patio and enjoy some lunch and splurge on yourself just because we deserve it based off of the weather we've had recently. Ash.
Yeah, absolutely. I can't wait to splurge on the rent, the power bill.
Listen, it's the 31st. The first of the month is right around the
there. But just a quick little meal.
Okay.
$10.
All right. You know, or Whitey's.
Whitey's. We'll take Whitey's.
That's a splurge fest right there. All righty. Here today, we are going to have a gorgeous summer-like day. This morning, you wouldn't really know it. There's the sun. There it is. How cute. It is hiding behind some clouds, but you can see the sun because these clouds are very thin. Very, very thin. So we're not going to be expecting them to stick around very long. As we warm up here, they should burn off quickly. So we're back to the mid-80s here today. 58 right now in Moline, 59 in Davenport. Wind out of the west-southwest, and that's just bringing that nice warm air for us to push us all the way into that mid-80 mark here today. So heading out the door, I mean, unless you're cold-natured, you might not even need a jacket. We're going to be back up to the 80s. Did you wear a jacket, Alexandria?
I did.
She did. Okay, so you might need a jacket if you're a weirdo, but otherwise... Just kidding. Just kidding. We're back to the upper 70s by lunchtime, mid 80s this afternoon, so right around 84 for that high temperature. And then tonight back down to the 60s as clouds increase ahead of some rain on the way by tomorrow. But it's going to be gorgeous today. You won't need the jacket this afternoon, I promise.
Okay, in my defense, I didn't know how I was going to feel when I got out the door, so I got ready.
Precautionary.
Yeah.
But since you've been out there, would you have worn a jacket?
No,
anyway?
I probably wouldn't have. But okay. I was already out the door. I'm not turning back.
That's fair.
Yeah. See? Right.
It all works out in the end.
Faith in me, guys. Faith in me.
Just a little bit.
All right, Ash, thanks.
Coming up, it's New Movie Friday.
What you need to know about everything hitting theaters this weekend, next with Movie Mike.
Time now. Coming up on 6:10, you're watching Local 4 News this morning.
WHBF is local for you. With Redrick Terry, Alexandria Ikomoni, and meteorologist Ash Simpson. This is Local 4 News This Morning in High Definition.